By pioneering the moving assembly line and mass producing the Model T, the Ford Motor Company became an iconic automobile leader. Ford is still a successful company, and it's a global brand, yet it's still reforming legacy systems. So new ideas must work their way through more than 100 years of company inertia and the sentiment of, that's not how we've done it before. When Tesla came along almost exactly a century later, it too started from scratch, free not to function like a typical automobile company. Tesla's business model is built on the idea that mobility is not constrained by the way things have always been done. So it embraces innovation and develops new technology, and it's continuously seeking new ways to improve its systems and products. So how can we apply these lessons to government? Well, it's a different landscape now than 70 years ago when our city charter was adopted. Globally, the digital revolution has disrupted traditional industries. Nationally, a populist revolt has sprung from the erosion of trust in government, as well as the fiscal stress of public debt. Here in California, we're enduring a housing affordability crisis, and pension liabilities have put a real strain on municipal budgets. We're living in a digitally charged world that no longer accepts a 20th century style of work. It demands that we deliver government services that are designed for the 21st century. A 21st century government delivers successful outcomes instead of just providing services. It manages performance to achieve results instead of managing operations to achieve compliance. A 21st century government has a fluid structure that fosters cross-disciplinary teamwork and collaboration instead of just having a rigid chain of command. New staff are hired for talent, potential, and fit, not just based on experience and credentials. The model of government acting as a vending machine is finished. The 21st century government engages the community to set shared priorities and seek collaborative solutions. So how can Santa Monica meet this challenge? While we continue to deliver high-quality performance, Santa Monica must be quicker and more agile at responding to our changing community. We need to be focused more on results and less on process. We need to be willing to innovate, to experiment, and pilot new ways of accomplishing our goals. As the hub of Silicon Beach, Santa Monica should be savvy about using technology to save time and money and deliver better results. We must be mobile and provide 24/7 digital services to our entire community. Santa Monica can harness data to make better decisions. Drilling down on data enables us to anticipate trends and to be transparent about our results. One of our greatest assets in Santa Monica is our talented workforce. By investing in training and development, we can empower our staff to be more nimble and more responsive. Santa Monica needs to realize we're not an island and we're not a monopoly. Our citizens compare us not to other cities like Los Angeles or West Hollywood, but to their experiences with businesses they use every day, like Apple or Amazon or even Tesla. So what is Santa Monica doing now? Well, we've established a citywide framework that focuses on measurable outcomes to enhance community sustainability and well-being. The council adopted specific strategic goals, and we've made real progress toward achieving them. We're implementing a performance management system across the board called SAMOSTAT, which focuses on quickly moving the needle on the results that matter most to our residents. We've launched the Total Workplace effort to make our workforce more mobile, our workspaces more flexible, and our work more collaborative. We've mapped out our digital strategy to revamp our online presence and digitize all of our services. We're deploying expanded outreach efforts that nurture community relationships and encourage two-way dialogue. Our city departments are pursuing new approaches to enhance communication and service delivery, to build stronger community partnerships, to foster civic engagement and policy innovation. All of these are moving us closer to delivering 21st century government to all our residents, but there's much more that we can do. So how will we know if we're successful? Well, we'll know we're successful if we've raised community trust and raise satisfaction in government. We'll know we're successful if we establish clear outcomes that are measured and reported on transparently, and they produce better results with more efficiency. We'll know we're successful if we maintain our fiscal health against all the looming threats: the leveling out of traditional revenues in a changing economy, our growing personnel and pension costs, the likelihood of a future recession, as well as the potential for federal and state cutbacks. We'll know we're successful if we achieve higher job satisfaction in our workforce and a better balance between expectations and capacity, so we're doing more of what works and less of what doesn't. Ultimately, we'll know this model is working when Santa Monica community members see themselves as active participants in their government and not just taxpayers and consumers, that they see they're part of the solution and that their contributions make a difference. Together, we can work toward this 21st century model of government. We can deliver on our commitment to achieve a thriving, sustainable city of well-being, a city that works for everyone.